has crossed the road by about 200 meters. These guys are going to push me on the, I'm going to sit on a motorbike and then they will push me so. I'm telling them, let me get off. But they want to push with me and the bike is stuck. What's the vehicle? The vehicle. So, as you can see, this is something else. I have arrived at my destination and that is Gulu City. Right now I am at Beach Comfort Hotel. So I am going to be here for about 2 or 3 days depending on the number of organizations that I will see.
I like it so much.
Why do you like it so much?
Yeah?
Why do you like it so much?
I've never seen you with this computer.
Yeah. I've used it for over 5 years now. And I'm used to it. When it breaks, or even if you give me a new one, I still may prefer using the one I
the one who has brought you to life.
To life.
So you wanted
took my ignorance. Not knowing, he just wanted. Okay, he indirectly wanted me to employ him. So each and every time, I give him money
to update
the website.
Money for internet.
Yeah, for internet. For internet, all those things.
Boy, use my ignorance.
So what happens now if you were to call him and ask him for the five?
For the
you think he can give you?
Then you can start from there.
That brown man is nice.
I know him.
He has done enterprise. And I don't have the key. You just can't activate, try again later. Change product key. Let me see the key which I have.
You have a Windows 10?
Windows 10 Pro.
Yes, good morning everyone. Still me once again. And I'm still at Beach Comfort Hotel. Today is day 6, and unfortunately it fell on a Sunday. That means fun day. There is no work. So today I am going to visit one of the most interesting places in Gulu. It's called Fort Batiko.
And like we have been explaining, we are now getting problems using these laptops. Sometimes with the charger, sometimes just with the laptops, like that. And these laptops, when we were still working in the office, we used to share it with other staff. We had seven.
Seven staff. And two laptops.
And one desktop. The printer, we had two, but now one is spoiled. The problem is only one which is working. We still maintain it. But at the moment, our capacity of maintaining it is not even there because all projects are still have still ended.
Yes.
So that is our major problem.
It is officially day 8 and I'm en route to Kitgum district, but I am going to pass via the famous roof wall.
I must say, coming back up from down there, it is not easy.
District. As you can see, the Airtel sign.
So, focusing more on the IT related challenges. So, currently, your organization has like how many people?
We are six.
You're six.
Committed members.
Committed members.
Yes.
And how many laptops do you produce?
We only have two laptops, individual laptops, which we share.
So, one, they are individual.
Individual.
That means it is not for the organization.
It is not for the organization.
And
we
two,
just
you share.
We share.
Okay.
Because we have roles played by all of us within the organization.
Mm.
So we keep sharing it to our paperwork. It comes to your desk like that. It makes the sometimes the work so slow. At the point of time where you feel you are in the mood of working.
Mm.
Sometimes you don't have the working machine and you are supposed to write it on the paper and also wait for another colleague to hand it over to you another day, then it loses a lot of sense.
It
keeps us so slow. Then the quality of data sometimes is even compromised. Then we even don't trust people, of course, within us, the way we take care of those safety precautions of those machines. Sometimes it is a little challenging. Find out someone may mishandle it, some damages here and there, and work comes at a standstill.
Attack. So this monument was built in loving memory of members of this family who were killed during the LRA war, which affected Northern Uganda for almost 20 years. So I'm from Kitgum. I met one organization in Kitgum, and right now I'm going to spend the night in Padel before I can proceed to Abim. As you can see from the sign there, it's about 40 kilometers to Padel, and take me about 2 hours maximum, but probably 1 hour and 30 minutes. Okay, thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. Yes, it's a beautiful day. The sun is out. The solar panel is outside charging as well. It is day 10 of our Security on Wheels tour, and I'm in Padel district. I was supposed to proceed to Abim yesterday, but it was late. So I am almost reaching Abim. It's about 16 kilometers, but I can tell you the scenery here. Magnificent. The place is very, very hilly. There are thousands and thousands of hills, as you can see them in the distance. Yeah, I'm entering Abim and I'm remaining with like 16 kilometers. As you can see, I'm just entering Abim, but unfortunately the water has crossed the road. Now, I can't tell how this is. Again, there is water. Officially, out of a barber, don't you? A barber taking off with water. another one, eh?
Oh. One last welcome.
Hey, it's kicking the inverter. That God is going to use it in the inverter.
Yeah, sure.
Maybe you can take it.
Mm-hmm. What are you saying?
You're going to tap our inverter. Yeah. Oh, thing doesn't work.
I take it out, eh? Oh, you...
It's okay.
I can take it out.
I take it somewhere where we can all see it and then build the appetite. If you hide it,
I...
That sign that is
cool
has gone off.
I thought something was wrong.
Oh, no.
Okay, so you have just started. That's one app. Now you look for another one.
So should I just
look for any which has a lot to continue?
Should I check my WhatsApp?
I'm going to be your phone is also a bit slow. File manager. Oh, can I click? Now music 65, images, now these are WhatsApp images, apps 26, text, this
WhatsApp status is
now,
also behind me.
I've never updated anything on
no,
WhatsApp.
No, for others, when you check, you find
you check people's status, you download them.
So you just go to all files.
So we are here in Awotid and about to start working for 1 or 2 hours before we can move on.
We have computers, like laptops, which are also in place. And sometimes, you know, these laptops also break down. And sometimes, probably organizations that you work with may not have something that is sufficient enough, like funding, which is not enough to make sure that these laptops are on board full time. For instance, we have about 3 laptops as an organization, and we have 2 laptops which are personal laptops, which are on board simply because we have those 2 which are down, and sometimes you will find people using their outdated laptops. Sometimes we nickname them local government laptops.
That's why you call this one local government.
Yes, it is called local government.
I didn't understand. I thought you would say it was given to you by local government.
It is day 12 and I'm concluding my tour in a beam. As you can see, I want to attempt to climb that hill up to the top. I'm with my colleague Charles, very good mountain climber, and he's saying I'm ready to sweat. And I'm going to sweat indeed. So it is day 12 and hopefully in the next 45 minutes we shall be on top of the hill. Security on the hill. You have to go in a zigzag motion. Otherwise, oh, can you imagine? I already want to rest. Wabitunu.
Wabio.
Wabio.
We left our.
Security on the hills. taking security
on the hill.
On the hill.
Hopefully the gods will be there.
I know they need some security as well. Good. The one called Jokamalu.
You can check out my brother, he's profusing with sweat. He says the challenge is better than going to a steam bar.
Good morning everyone. Today is day 13 and it is still security on wheels. We are on the road today saying bye bye to Abim district. I have been joined on the journey by my friend Charles of Youth Forum for Social Justice. So we are hitting the road due to Kotido together. Then we shall proceed to Kabong and again we shall come back together and he will leave me and then I proceed. So it is still security on wheels and I would like to say Abim was a wonderful place and I would really love to come back to it. For now, it's time to head to Kotido with my friend Charles.
That's right.
Okay. We peace. So it is day 13 and we are in Kotido. The first thing that we wanted to get as soon as we reached was buying this. I understand. It is called what?
Nakatuko.
Nakatuko. This is called Nakatuko.
Thank you.
basing on the submission, I would say the sum of the challenges. I want to start with the challenges. Though achievements also will come there, but I want to start with the challenges. Some of the challenges that Maroa has been facing, you know, being a small organization and starting something, we have not stayed for long. I think when we got the funding from Masipo, in partnership with Masipo, with the support of the USSC, that's when we became active. We see we also had now staff, repeated 11 staff. And basically, we have been partnering with the Uganda Women Network, who gave us only one computer. And that is the computer that you see in the desktop. Gave us a desktop. And that is what we have been using. And using these computers, you line up.
Today we are heading to Kabong, where we shall finish the journey from, and there is one organization that we are going to support in Kabong. We are still on the road with Charles, and I can say it has been a wonderful journey having him with me. It's good to have company. So we are leaving Kotido right now, and hopefully in the next 1 hour and 30 minutes we shall be in Kabong. Security on the wheels, see you soon. So this is the full security on wheels. We are on the way to Kabong, and as you can see, we have come across a beautiful monument. Yes, so now we're to Kabong. We have found some two guys. Their bike has a flat tire, and we wanted to assist them, but I think we don't have all the tools. In my box here, I only have a tube and a pump, but they are those tools they use for opening the tire. So we are going to take them back. There's a town ahead of us where we are going, and they can fix their bike. It's still security on wheels. Thank you. We are still on the road. Security on wheels. Today is day 15, and we are in Kabong district. We have an organization we are going to support. But first, we are going to Kidepo National Park to see giraffes and elephants and any other animals that are there. So I'm still with Charles on the road, and those children you see going are actually from mining gold. I understand they have a method of picking the gold, but I'm sure they are richer than they went down there. So. As you can see, antelope. They are very many and they are very big. I think the lions are not active, maybe due to the corona. They are very big. Eh? I thought they were very small. Look at that. I think they are even almost bigger than cows. Eh? Those are antelopes. And they are big. Eh? Are the lions here working? I think the lions are not working. They are on. They're walking from home.
So we have moved up to Kidepo National
Park. They are very welcomed us. So Apoha Vista Center. Is this a reception?
This is for viewing. So it looks, I think it's like a binoculars.
Really, it works.
I think they want to go to the
Let them go.
This where are the lions?
Can we see them?
You in here. If
you had a night camera, you would actually see.
because now they are moving from the lodge.
They have a plan of crossing.
They will cross.
Where are they?
They are still coming around the lodge.
What's wrong with this?
They were roaring at the lodge, at the Safari lodge. Now they should be planning to walk and cross around the lodge. If we remain here, they can easily cross from there.
So you break fast here at night?
Don't worry, this is their home. Is that where their home
We are the ones in their home.
We are sweet for them. Yes, good morning everyone. So we are ready to go for the game drive, and it is now security on four wheels, as you can see. Our guide Simon is here and he has already given us some brief introduction of the park, and let's not delay them any further. Peace. And I'm very happy that I finally at least came on the ground. Really, I can say for the past 2 days, there is work to be done.
Yeah.
There is a lot of challenges facing us with the IT department. I have tried my level best to fix some of these devices, but I can assure you that some of them actually need replacement. There is really not much I can fix beyond that. The best is now maybe to look for ways of getting new devices. I've seen desktops which do not work. Really just signal that needs another one. And I've noticed also from my engagement with the staff, some of them do not have the basic training in security.
Security.
People are having a very easy to guess password, they have some lack of password. That clearly shows that you need a comprehensive security audit and security training for the organization. Because it's through that you can improve their capacity to even perform their duties as staff. And I can say, yes,
there's really lack of support for that organization because the work we're doing for the community is tremendous, but the problem is visibility is not there. And that's why I came to see that I can shine a light on the problem. Had a small fall, and my precious energy companion, power bank, umeme, yaka, and everything, the solar panel broke, as you can see. The glass is shattered, it's bent. I don't know whether the cells still work. Yeah, I broke one of the most important rules which I set for myself when I was starting this journey, and that was never to ride above 80 kilometers per hour. And I think by the time I fell, I was riding at about 95 kilometers per hour, which was a bit risky. And luckily enough, I have a lot of body protection.
Yes, good morning everyone. This is Still Security on Wheels. I'm heading back to Kampala. Right now I'm in a beam with Charles. We are from Potido, where we spent a night yesterday, and this is where we part ways with Charles and until we meet again. Otherwise, his presence throughout the trip has been very, very important, and he gave me the courage and the comfort during the trip. It's not very easy, and I would like to say, Charles, thank you very much, and we look forward to linking up.
Yes, good morning everyone. It is Still Security on Wheels. We are on the road heading back to Kampala via Lira. The time check is 10:17, as you can see, due to the rain, getting back to Kampala is not going to be easy. We are still on the Maram Road. We are in a town called Olilim. Yeah, had a small accident, and as you can see, the mechanic is trying to fix it. It's minor. I didn't get an accident. As you can see, I am really dressed for this kind of terrain, but the solar panel again has suffered the loss. As you can see, the box is I think it's okay, and the bike steering or handle has been dislocated, but
security on wheels heading back to Kampala. We are still on the road, some small fall, but we are back on the road. Bike has been fixed. As I said, getting back is the hard part. Coming was easy. Woo. Okay, peace.
The road is very bad. Woo. Look at my shoes.
I wish I knew. Anyway,
I wish I knew doesn't help now. Let me try and get out of this mud as fast as I can, as safe as I can. Otherwise, peace.
This is the worst road I've ever been. stuck in the mud yet. I don't know why it's called a mud yet. So the whole of inside here, there is mud. And the front tire can't rotate any longer. There's some drag force in the front tire. I think they need to remove some mud. Otherwise, it feels so good to hit the tarmac. Goodbye, Andy Maram. Woo! Security on wheels, day 21, 12 hours riding. I'm happy to be back home, safe and sound. It's been a tough one. Signing out, peace.